The sound of Philadelphia's 95.7 Philly's new jam and go. We're cooking like a pressure cooker inside. Going down to 40 degrees sunny.
This week on Life, how globalization is changing the future of work in the world's biggest economy.
Kicking off another music jam.
His father works some days for 14 hours, and you can bet he barely makes a dollar.
Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love, where America declared independence. America is booming. Record growth, record job creation.
Living just enough for the city.
But there is another Philadelphia story, the story of what happens to those in the global economy who don't quite make it. Inner city Kensington has seen thousands of jobs go to competitors overseas. Those who've lost out find brotherly love in the offices of the Kensington Welfare Rights Union.
Hi.
Hi, fellow photographer.
How are you?
Hi, yeah. Nice to meet you. Yeah. Hey, if everybody wants to come and start getting on the bus.
A busload of activists with a busload of faith. They are few today, but even some close to the Clinton White House believe that one day they could be many.
The people who are most hurt right now by globalization are blue-collar and relatively poor workers who used to have the factory jobs in the developed nations. And unless we come up with a solution for their plight, their insecurities, and sometimes in some nations their lack of jobs, we are going to see a backlash against globalization that will hurt all of us ultimately.
First stop, a lighting company where two-thirds of the jobs have gone to Asian competitors in the last 2 years.
We just want to welcome the sisters and brothers from the United Electrical Workers and want to thank you for allowing us to visit you today and hear about the struggle that you're dealing with.
I started here 28 years ago with $2.10. 28 years later, I'm only making $11. That's a disgrace.
I'm 57 years old, will soon be 58, and I've spent all my time with Philadelphia Glassman. It would be hard for me to go someplace and try to get another job someplace.
The problem that the workers in this local are running into lately is that more and more production jobs have been lost here at Philadelphia Glassbending because this company's competitors are bringing in the same products from Korea and Taiwan at a far lower cost. And I'm fighting against this corporate greed-driven race to the bottom on wages, living standards, and environmental issues, where the country that'll sell its labor for the cheapest price will attract all the corporations and their factories and their money and...
Only one in four of those who lose factory jobs will find another that pays as well. America has lost almost 1 million manufacturing jobs in 30 years. This garment factory has lost 95% of its workers in a decade.
We don't mind fair competition. England is fair competition, Germany is fair competition, France, but not Asia, where people work 12 hours, 18 hours a day, get 50 cents an hour, get 20 cents, and some of it is taken away from him, and so on. So how can we compete? There is no justice. We're looking for justice. I don't know how we're going to find it unless globalization, unless the Western countries get together and say enough is enough, we want fair trade, fair competition.
For the people abroad, bad, I don't think it's good news for them because they can't even buy what they make.
But the rate of job loss in American manufacturing is now declining, and bad news in America may be good news elsewhere.
I do not think that it's possible to argue that globalization is anything but a progressive force because essentially it's a very efficient engine for matching capital up to labor, and it employs people where you know they can be used most productively in the world economy. The problem comes in a particularly developed countries when you get low-skilled workers whose jobs compete directly against workers in poor countries, and every job that's lost in Britain or the United States may result in three or four jobs being created in Malaysia or Vietnam or some other poor country. That is a net gain, it seems to me, to global welfare.
But a local inequality. And